Hi folks, and thanks for joining us for another one of these pop-up webinars. My name is Sebastian Bleek, and in a little bit we're going to be joined by Nicholas Vanderwall and the other folks over at Astute Towers. All right, so today what we're going to be going over is pattern brushes and how you could use Astute Graphics plugins to build them and make some changes to them to get some really cool effects. All right, so this is something native in Adobe Illustrator, and you could play around with these from the width part of it. You can play around with it from CS5 and above, but the pattern brush has been around for a really long time. So let's check this out. Right here in front, I have this pattern brush already set up. I'm gonna hit Command Y to go into outline mode. And that's just showing you one single path going along here. But if I go back into preview mode, you see this really cool appearance applied to it. Now, the reason this is happening is if you look over here on the right, I got my brushes panel set up and I got this little shoelace pattern brush already set up. So I'm gonna show you how to build this guy. And when you set up a brush like this, you could end up making some pretty cool effects really quick in Illustrator, like this guy that I have set up over here in the top. Now, this is where I was talking about CS5. What I did with this was I was able to play around with the stroke widths to start getting a little bit more of a fun look. It starts looking more alive now. It doesn't look as static as it would have without that. So I'm gonna hit Command 1 to go into 100%. And let me just move this guy out of the way. Bring this guy up to the top, because I'm going to use this as a template to set up my new pattern brush. All right, so while I have this guy selected over here in the top, in the control panel, I'm going to drop this down to about 50. Hit enter, return on the keyboard a couple times to accept that. And while I have this object selected, I'm going to hit Command 2, and that's going to lock this guy down. This way I don't mess anything up, because I'll probably move it around, and I need it to just stay put in one spot. All right, so a closer look is going to show that we pretty much have this guy broken down into two sections. We have this shoelace portion here, and then we have this aglet over here on the left and on the right. So I'm going to create the shoelace part first, and let me get in a little bit closer for that. All right, so this is just a basic shape. So I'm going to come over here, grab my dynamic shapes, click on that guy to activate it, and I'm just going to click and drag. Now I'm drawing off from the side right now, from the edge. So if I hit the S key, it's going to come back to create from center. And this is how your dynamic shapes are by default. So if you want to switch the behavior, just hit S and it's going to come off from the side. And right now I'm drawing a square and I need a rectangle. So I haven't let go of the mouse yet. And if I cycle through my keys right there, that's a 2 key, 3, 4, 5, 6. It shows you all the different shapes we have access to. So I'm going to hit the number 3 key so I get my dynamic rectangle. And with the space bar, I'm just going to reposition this guy. So if you take a look over in the upper left section, I'm just trying to get this guy lined up. All right, I'll release the space bar and just try to set myself up over here in the bottom right. All right, now that I have this shape laid out how I need it, I haven't let go of the mouse yet. I'm gonna hold down the Alt or Option key on my keyboard and come in towards the center. And once I get this guy set up how I need, I'll go ahead and release the mouse. All right, so what it's done is it actually applied this pattern brush that we already had on there, because that was the last thing I selected. If I hit the D key, it's just going to give me the default appearance again of a white fill with a black stroke. All right, since I am working with the pattern brush, I need to expand these guys. I need to just work with expanded shapes. So I have this guy selected, and you're going to see me come over here to the object menu and expand a bunch of times. All right, so we're going to expand the fill and stroke. I'll click OK. Now you see over here we don't have a stroke, so I know I'm in a good position right now. All right, I'm going to click and drag, move this guy down a little bit. And so far what we have is two shapes right here. So I'm gonna grab my direct selection tool, click and drag. We have this white shape over here at the bottom, and then we just have this black stroke going along here. All right, let me undo that so you can get back together. Next, what I need to do is create this little pattern you see that I have going on in here. All right, a quick way to do that is I come over here to the tools panel and grab this line segment tool. And you see there's a keyboard shortcut for that, it's a slash. On the American keyboard, it's the key just below the delete key in the upper right section. All right, so let me just click and drag on this guy. And I'm holding down the shift key so I can get this little slant going. And I'll release, I'm gonna hit the D key to give it the default appearance. And then I'm gonna hit the question mark key or slash key to get rid of that fill. All right, the V key is gonna give me the selection tool. I'm gonna option, click and drag on this and holding down the shift key as well to make sure everything's nice and straight. Once I get this gap, however I need it, I'm gonna go ahead and release. Illustrator is gonna remember that distance for me. So if I hit Command D, it's gonna duplicate that last transformation for me. I just wanna make sure I fill in this shape. All right, V is gonna give me my selection tool again. Click and drag, come along this way. Now I have all these guys selected. Command G to group them. I'm gonna hit O to grab my reflect tool. Click and drag. Now, if I bring the shift key, it's going to make everything nice and straight for me. And if I hold down the option key, you see my cursor changes. And now I have a double cursor there. And that's letting me know it's going to make a copy of that shape. So I'll go ahead and release that. And now I have this little pattern that I need. All right, so let me select all these guys. Make sure they're all grouped. And let me scoot it over a little bit so I could cover in all that area. Let me see. I want to make sure that the one on the left is set up properly. All right around there looks good to me. And let's see, over here again, we're going to go to Object, Expand. Okay, now we just have fills. All these guys are just expanded shapes. So I'm going to come over to the Pathfinder. And you can find that by coming to Window, scrolling down, finding Pathfinder. On my keyboard, on my machine, I have a keyboard shortcut of Command-Shift-F9. So I click on that, and it's going to bring up the panel for me. I want to unite these guys. So when I click on that, it smushed everybody together. Now it's just one piece. I kind of think of this as like the like a pie crust type of thing, especially with these little crisscrosses going along here. So this is all of my dough. This is all excess dough coming out right here. So I need to cut this out using a cookie cutter. So let me deselect this guy and zoom in a little bit with the direct selection tool. Hit the A key to activate it. I'm going to select this white portion once, and I'll zoom out a little bit. Command C to copy it onto my clipboard. All right. Now I'm going to select all this extra pattern stuff, all this dough. Command F so that it's on top of that or in front. I'm going to paste it in front of that shape. Shift click on it to select everybody. And back over here in Pathfinder, I'm going to choose this intersect option. When I click on that, it got rid of all that extra dough that we had hanging out here. And now our pie has this nice crust on top. But if I hit Command H to hide the edges, you don't really see anything there. And that's because it changed the color for it. If you look over here in the tools panel, the color is white. So back over here in the swatches, while I have that guy selected, I'm just going to click on black. And there you go. So now we have it all set up. Looks really good. All right. So let me select all these guys and just group them together. Make sure everybody's in one piece. All right. So this portion is done. And like I said earlier, we're going to start working on this other section right over here. All right. So now we got the aglet. And this is just a basic shape. So again, I'm going to come over here to my dynamic shapes tool, click on it to activate it. And I'm just going to come right here to the white, click and drag. Now check that out. It's remembering the corner information that we put in earlier. So I'm going to hit the option key to get rid of it. Spacebar to reposition this guy. So the upper left section is what I'm trying to align. I got rid of the spacebar. Now I'm just going to align the bottom section right here. And as long as I'm going a little bit beyond this shoelace, I'm pretty good. All right, so I'll go ahead and release this guy. I'm going to grab my dynamic corners, click on this corner, click on this corner over here, and that just rounded things off for me really quickly. I'm going to hit the D key to give me the default appearance of a white fill and a black stroke, and it's pretty much set up. All right, so let me just click and drag on this guy, holding down Shift, and check this out. It's going to snap to the right spot. Right there, it's intersecting. Now release. The reason it was doing that is I have my smart guides turned on. You could turn them on and off by hitting the Command U key. That keyboard shortcut will toggle between having them on or off. All right, so let's take a look at this guy. All right, so I have these lines right here kind of creating a little bit of shape, but somebody pointed out to me that this is super wrong. It actually looks like it's dipping down instead of coming up, so we're going to fix that. So if it was bothering you guys, we'll take care of that right now. All right, so I'm going to hit the slash key to get my my line segment tool. I'm going to click and drag on this guy, hold down the shift key to make sure it's nice and straight, and with the space bar, I'm going to reposition it. All right, now that I got in the right spot, I'm going to go ahead and release. And there we go. So I have this segment set up. And with the V key, that gives me the selection tool. Option, click and drag, holding down the shift key. And once I get this guy lined up, I'm going to go ahead and release. All right, so these two are good, but I need to change the size over here in the appearance panel. I'm going to switch over to half a point. So now they're nice and thin. I'll make a copy of this guy. Option, click and drag. Right here to the center, and the smart guides are on, so that helped me out. I released. All right, so just have this single guy selected in the middle. This one's going to be a little bit thicker because it's going to be closer to you, and it's going to be more accurate than that old one was. All right, so I selected all three of these segments, and what we're going to do is we're just going to create a blend. All right, so let's see, what is that? The W key is going to activate your blend tool. When I hover over the first segment, I get this little asterisk, so I know I'm in the right spot. I'll click on that. I'm going to come over here. I get this little plus symbol saying I could add to that blend. I come over here to this other segment. I get the plus symbol again. So that one has been added to the blend. Now, we need to make some edits to this. So I'm going to come over here, double click on the blend, click preview so I can see what's going on. I'm going to switch over to specified steps. And then I'm just going to hit the down arrow key a couple times until I get the look I'm going for. All right, that looks pretty good. I'll click OK. Now we're all set up. So again, over here, I got to go to Object. I want to expand the blend. I'm going to click OK. Now over here in the Tools panel, I see that I still have the stroke, so I know I haven't expanded it all the way. So I'm going to come back over here to Object, Expand, click OK. And now that it's just fills, I know that I've expanded those shapes exactly to how I need them. All right, cool. So let me zoom out and make sure these guys are grouped. Command G, bring it down over here. I'm holding down the Shift key to make sure it's straight. And again, my smart guides are going to snap everybody into place. All right, I'm going to select both of these shapes. Shift M is going to give me my Shape Builder tool. And I can Shift Option, click and drag right here to get rid of these segments. And again, Shift Option, click and drag, and release. And now I got rid of this section here. All right, I want to make sure these guys are all grouped. So Command G, there you go. So if you take a look at the one on the top, this looks like a pretty cool shoelace. It has this aglet over here tucked in. But the one on the bottom kind of looks like a weird fingernail or something. So, and that's just because of their arrangement. So I'm going to select this portion right here, this little aglet, Command Shift, open bracket, and that's going to send it to the back. And now we got the look that we're going for. All right, cool. I'm going to zoom out a little bit. Now we got to start chopping this guy up a little bit. All right, so we're going to break this into a couple different sections, and then we're going to create the pattern brush. All right, so I want to set up my guides first, so I got a good starting point. Let me see. Let me zoom out. I actually liked this portion better, so let me rotate this guy because I want to keep everything on the left. There we go. All right, cool. I got 1, 2, 3 little white triangles right here, so let me zoom in on that. And I have my rulers up over here. So if you hit Command R, it's gonna turn them off or on. If you click and drag on that ruler, you could bring in a guide. Right now I'm bringing in a vertical guide, and I'm gonna use this anchor point so I could snap in the right location. All right, so we got this guy set up. Over here on this side, I got 1, 2, 3, and it doesn't really matter, but I just wanna make sure I get it in the right spot. So at the moment, I'm dragging out a horizontal guide, but if I hold down the Option key, it's gonna switch up and give me this vertical guide. And I just want to make sure I'm coming over here to the peak of that white triangle. And I got that anchor point highlight. So when I release, I know I'm in the exact spot that I need to be. All right, cool. Zoom back out and deselect those guys. All right, now I need to start breaking this up. So let me use the dynamic shapes. Click on this. I'm going to click and drag. What I'm doing is just kind of creating a guide for the shape builder to use when it's cutting it up. So Shift M is going to give me the shape builder tool again. Option Shift, click and drag, we get to this guide and release. Oops, I actually needed to select both those guys. Here we go. Or else it doesn't know. Oops, my guides are turned on. So over here, lock these guys down by going to View, finding Guides, and you want to lock them down. And there's also a keyboard shortcut of Command Option semicolon. All right, cool. Now those guys won't get in my way. All right, I select both of these guys, Shift M, Option Shift, click and drag. And we'll come over here to the edge and release. All right. So that one's set up properly. We'll come back over here. I need to make a copy of this guy. Option, click, and drag. Here we go. Now, there's another way you could chop these sections off. I don't need this piece. You could use your eraser tool. So let me select this guy. Shift E to bring up the eraser tool. And let me just zoom in a little bit so I can make sure I got a good view of this. All right. What I need to do is Option, click, and drag. And it gives me this little marquee behavior. I'll get over here to this guide and release. All right, let me deselect, make sure I got it right. Actually, I got a little bit hanging out. Let me try that again. All right, Shift E. I'll zoom in a little bit more, make it easier on me. All right, Option, click and drag. There we go, using this guide and release. Boom, once I deselect, you see it's perfect. All right, cool. So now I have this little shoelace portion, but I need this aglet portion to be by itself. So let me get rid of this section over here. I'll zoom in on this guy a little bit more. Shift E for the eraser tool. Option, click, and drag. Come over here. Once I get to this guide, release. Cool. Everything looks great. I want to make sure these guys are grouped because I don't want to lose. I don't want to lose them. I don't want to move them around. All right, cool. We have everything we need. Now let's start making this pattern brush. Bring up your brushes panel by coming over here to the window menu, scrolling down until you find brushes, or you could hit F5. All right, so I got my brushes up over here. I'm going to select this shoelace portion, and I'm just going to click and drag. Bring it over here to brushes. Once I release, I'm greeted with this window here. It says new brush, and I got a couple options. It says scatter brush, art brush, but the one I'm looking for is pattern brush. So I'll click on that and then click OK to accept. All right, cool. So right here gives me an option to name this guy. So I'm gonna call this guy shoelace. 2015. And let's come back down here. Now, I'm working on Illustrator CC 2014. So if you're with the Creative Cloud, you have access to this new feature here where it's automatically going to try to generate the corners for you. So Illustrator thought that auto sliced would be the best corner for me. So I'm going to go ahead and use that for this outer corner. Over here for the side tile, we're using that original shoelace piece. Over here, we're missing that inner corner. So if I click on this drop down, you see we have access to these auto corners. And because we're already using auto sliced, I'm going to go ahead and choose that one, and it looks great. Last, we have the little aglets we need to add. So if I click on this drop down, I don't have access to them just yet. So let me show you how to bring those guys up. I'll click OK to accept that. I want to deselect this guy because I want to make sure I don't add some crazy appearance to it. All right, so over here I have my swatches up. If you don't have them up, you go to the window menu, scroll through until you find swatches. But mine are up already. What I want to do is make a copy of this guy. Option, click and drag. O, click and drag, hold down shift and release. All right, so now I have the left and the right aglet. I'm going to select this guy. Click and drag, bring it over here, and release. I'm gonna grab this dude, click and drag, and release. Now that they're over here in the swatches panel, check this out. Make sure you deselect everything. Come back to the brushes, double click on shoelace 2015. Now, when you go into this drop-down menu, you have access to these guys. All right, so we're doing the start point, so I'll click on that, and look, I actually put in the wrong one. If you put in the wrong one, don't worry, you could always come back over here and just make an edit. So I'll click on that one, there you go. Come over here, choose that one, and now the ends look good. So it's pretty cool having this little preview right here. All right, I'll click OK to accept that, and we're set. So let me get rid of all this stuff and zoom out a little bit. All right, great. So I'm gonna grab my line segment tool again, get rid of these guides, click and drag to just draw this straight segment. All right, so it has just this black stroke, as you can see over here in the tools panel. Back in the brushes, if I click on shoelace 2015, boom, check that out. So now we have this shoelace brush. The cool thing about it is we don't have to redraw this thing every time we want to make some edits to it. So zoom in a little bit more on this guy. I'm going to come over here to the tools panel, and I want to grab my passcribe tool. So I'll click on it to activate it. And I'm going to come over here and just grab one of these little ghost handles, click and drag. And when I release, you see it's been updated along that path. Coming along over here, click and drag. And you see it updates going along that path again. If I hit Shift-W, remember, this is going to be something for CS5 and above users. Click and drag. That's going to change the stroke width for you right there. So that's how you're going to start getting some really cool looks. So now you can start guessing how this is going to look when you start playing around with it using Astute Graphics plugins. So let me just grab my Wacom tablet real quick. Just want to fire this dude up. I'm going to use the pencil tool to just lay out some paths for me pretty quickly. Oops, I got that touch thing on, so it's messing me up. And it's funny, Hana always tells me to turn it off, but I don't listen. All right, so here we go. S-E-B. I figured I'd just put my name since I know how to spell that. There you go. And now I rounded this part off because if I create a little cusp right here, it's going to give it a really ugly look. So there we go. So using the Wacom tablet, you see I get a little bit more free forms going along with this. Now check this out. If I come over here and grab this S, I'm going to come over here to the Tools panel and find my Width Gradient tool. I'll click on it to activate it. Window, I want to find my Width Scribe, my Width Gradient panel. And I just want to check my settings. I have it set to end at 200 and start at 100. Let me bring this down to 75%. All right, so while I have this shape selected, I'm just going to click and drag, stretch this guy out, and release. So check that out. Now it's giving me this cool little effect here. And if I wanted to add that to all these guys, I could do it at the same time. So let me select everybody right here with gradient, click and drag. And then you start getting a little bit more of a dynamic look. It starts giving your artwork a little bit more flow. Well, there you have it, folks. That's the demo we had prepared for you guys today. If you have to take off, we really appreciate you guys coming by and checking us out. Please keep an eye on our social media feed so you can find out when the next pop-up webinar is going to be. And for those of you guys that can stick around, please get your questions ready because we're about to be joined by Nicholas Vanderwall, founder of Astute Graphics.